you pretty well, don't they? Folks, welcome to the 2001 Barnyard Barnyard Bash.
evening prayer. Good evening.
They're out there, I know they are. I can hear them breathing.
I can't see them. WCRC would like to welcome you tonight to the 10th anniversary of the Barnyard Bash. Tonight is a very... Would you like to applaud to that? About 14 years ago, two very special people came to join the family of CRC. They're Larry and Sarah Bills. As many of you know already, they will be leaving us in June of this year. I need to read part of what I've got down here, and I'm going to have to put my glasses on because I can't see it. WCRC would like to say thank you, Mr. Bills. Thank you for your patience, your understanding, your prayers, your sacrifice, your hard work, and support that you've given to WCRC over these years. We realize it was not an easy task to work with all of us women. Some might say you might be nominated for sainthood. But Sarah, that's another thing. WCRC wants all of you, and Sarah too, to know how much we appreciate her, how much she has done for WCRC and for Crowley's Ridge College. Sarah is a Christian woman. She's a loving wife who honors her husband. She's raised two beautiful Christian children. On top of that, she became president of WCRC. And just as soon as she did, she issued a wake-up call, and I know it was heard all the way around the world. She said, "Wake up, ladies, let's go to work." And go to work we did. She planned. We had activities. She set goals. And look where it got us. When sometimes we thought, well, maybe we'd rest a while, but no, no. She built a fire, she kept adding fuel, and we began to burn. Brighter and bigger, every year we got bigger. She is a never ever ending source of energy and dedication to Christian education. We need to show Sarah that her work is appreciated. We need to show her how much we love her, how much we feel that she's done for Christian education. Many of you received in the mail a letter asking for support to help us establish a scholarship in her name. We set a goal of $10,000. This scholarship will be $1,000 per year given to a sophomore girl. We will put the money that you've sent us into an endowment fund so that it will be an ongoing scholarship for many, many years to come. WCRC has also pledged that until this endowment reaches a time that it matures enough to give the student that $1,000 each year, we at WCRC will fund the scholarship through various projects that we have. To date, we have collected $8,235. On the tables in front of you are envelopes and cards that say, "Let's honor Sarah." Folks, help us out. We need a few more $1,000. Let's dig a little deeper. We can all get another dollar or two. Help us show Sarah how important she is to all of us. On this 10th anniversary of the Barnyard Bash, which, by the way, was one of Sarah's little ideas. But even though I can't see you, it looks more like an extravaganza to me. Let's really show our appreciation. Sarah, would you come up here, please?
The show. Y'all might want to get back up. I know this next fella would much appreciate it. How about a nice hand for Mr. Evan Smith tonight?
Love to sing, and everyone is different.
what we say is that has a variety of talent, a variety of ages, and for that matter, a variety of styles of songs. The next two guests we have coming out are a couple of young people, I believe, eighth graders, that happened to go to church with me at Center Hill, and I think a whole lot of both of them and their families as well. How about it for Garrett Webb and Mary Palmer?
On my VCR, and I bought myself a computer. That right there's where I found him.
over the internet.
The internet?
Oh, yeah. www.princecharming.com. I'm telling Lulu and Farine about that one, too. Yeah, they got somebody there.
Well, where's this old Alvis from?
Well, he's from Burt Mattress, Arkansas.
Burt Mattress, Arkansas?
Yeah, Burt Mattress.
I don't think I've ever heard of that. Where's that located?
Oh, it's just a little bit above Hot Springs. This was the perfect time. Look at that crowd out there. You know, I didn't have to spend nothing on wedding invitations.
I guess not.
Yeah.
Well, what does this Alvis look like?
Well, I don't know. Never seen him before. No, but you know, it doesn't matter. Doesn't matter this time. I've had lots of fine-looking fellas ask me for dates, and not a one of them asked me to marry him. So this time, I'm just looking on the inside. That's all that counts. This time, just the inside.
I sure hope you're not too disappointed there, Minnie.
No, I won't be. I won't be.
What's old Alvis do for a living?
Well, one thing he does is he sings.
He sings?
Oh, yeah. He's got the prettiest voice you've ever heard, Grandpa.
Well, now, wait a minute. If you met him over the internet, how do you know what his singing voice sounds like?
Oh, well, he recorded a song one time.
Oh, he did?
Yeah, he did. Oh, yeah, he recorded that song in his basement. It was a big seller. It was called Stay Out of the Wheat Fields, Grandma. You're going against the grain. I think he's gone through all that money that he made off of that song, and I think he's broke now.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Oh, he told me the other night that he was so hungry, he had to go down to KFC just to lick everybody's fingers. but I don't think Alvis is a failure. No, I don't. I think he just started at the bottom, and he likes it there. Oh, Grandpa.
What?
I'm worried.
Worried about
well,
what?
Well, I don't know. Do you think we did the right thing about asking Lulu to cater this wedding reception tonight?
Well,
you know what a cook she is.
I sure hope so. No. I tell you what, you know what she's been doing lately, though?
No, what?
She's been feeding that dehydrated food straight out of the package to Junior.
Oh,
yeah,
I
straight
that.
Out of the package. Remember that big rain we had the other day?
Yeah.
Old Junior walked out in that rain and gained 50 pounds.
Oh, he did. Well, you know, Grandpa, that when we were growing up, fiber, that was just a word that pertained to the textile industry.
Well, yeah,
and now they tell you got to have it every day. If you don't have it every day, you might as well be going to your lawyer and making sure your will's all in order. I don't know fiber stuff.
I know we had innocent sounding cereals like Cheerios and Frosted Flakes.
Yeah,
that's now they got all that newfangled stuff like Fiber One.
Yeah.
You know, that sounds like a race car. What's that other? Nitrograin. That sounds like something you feed a cow out in Nebraska feedlot.
Yeah. I don't think that's
what, where I get my fiber, though, is this product 19.
Oh, product 19.
I always wondered, though, whatever happened to products 1 through 18?
I wonder too.
Well, listen, you're looking good yourself.
Well, thank you.
Is that a new dress you got on there?
Oh, no, this old dress is probably 25 years old.
Well, yeah. It's looking good for the shape it's on.
You and Junior, you know what Junior told me the other day?
What was that?
He said, Minnie, you just need to treat your figure like it's in a battle.
In a battle?
Yeah. He said you just ought to regroup and bring up the reinforcements. That wasn't very nice.
No, it wasn't.
He said, Minnie, your figure don't add up. Well, it adds up all right, but there's too much left over to carry.
Well, now, don't you worry about that, Minnie. There are other things men look at.
Really?
Yeah.
Like?
Charm. Poise.
Mm-hmm.
Brains.
Brains? I ain't never caught a feller yet whistling at a girl's brains.
Listen, you been on any trips this year?
Oh, yeah. Lulu and Faye and me, we went to New York City.
New York City?
Yeah, I had to take my time. Woo, I wouldn't want to live there, though.
Why is that?
It's hurry-scurry, just everybody's in such a hurry, fast pace. Why, if somebody got the 7-year itch there, they'd have it scratched out in a year and a half. Oh, we had a good time, though. We went to one of them department stores, you know.
Yeah.
Well, Fairing was looking for a new dress. So this salesman, he came up to help her. You know, he's pretty cute. Fairing winked at him a couple times. So he'd want to help her. So she put on this little dress. And so he said, now, if you take off this little jacket here, you got yourself a little sunsuit. Yeah. So but he said, now, if you take off this little skirt here, you got yourself a little bathing suit.
Uh-oh.
And Fairy said, mister, you take off anything else, and you've got yourself a lawsuit.
Walking now, boy, I
both would go. He grown old and gray and his mind was wandering. Daddy took me by the hand, said I know where we're going and I understand. He said, don't worry, boy, you'll be all right. Good harmony, and I heard these guys warming up outside before the show started, and they sang like birds. Of course, I sing like a bird, but it is a crow. But these folks really sing. How about a big hand for the Jared?
We changed chords on Debbie. She wasn't here last night. John's got a bad cold.
This bird's eating too much.
We're gonna just try it here.
All the gold in California is in a bank in the middle of Beverly Hills. Is somebody else's name? So maybe you're dreaming about California. Karen Pillow.
Miracle before
considering some of the preachers I know around here, I think the first place I'll look is hotair.com. Well, take it easy, Lulu. Hadn't you ever fallen in love before?
I don't guess I ever fallen in love, but I sure have stepped in it a few times. Oh, well. Since Lulu's Diner's catering reception, we better go over our list of food we got for the reception, for the wedding. Don't you like my idea of having a tailgate reception?
Hey, I do. I don't have to carry all that food inside the building now.
I just think eating off the back end of a tailgate of a truck is just kind of romantic-like.
Yeah. Well, let's see. Let's go over the list here. Okay, food for the wedding reception. Fahini sausages.
Check.
Beanie weenies.
Check.
Cabbage rolls.
Check.
Cabbage rolls. Ooh-wee. From the looks of this list of food, Minnie and her new husband's gonna have a blast on their wedding day. Get there. why did you do that? Why do they do that?
Well, for anything that you might see on the Discovery Channel, that's what it is. They all decorate their houses in this liquor print stuff. That's what I wanted to do.
Okay.
Yeah. It's a style of the fashion. It's called the Safari Collection. And it has in all the magazines, in that Vogue magazine, you know.
It is in Vogue.
And we're going to do exactly what is in style. So, you want to see what we got now?
Yes, I'd like to see it. They would do.
The Safari. This is a leopard print crock pot. I wanted something in style that she could use every day, be practical and stylish. Leopard print crock pot, and I got something else, since there's two of us, I got two pieces. To go in the bathroom. A sandy print toilet set.
Sandy Jet, I'm a kill for that thing.
And to continue the safari look, I just put a picture on the inside of it. And this little egg seems very cute. This little egg on the inside.
Now, Lulu, I think you're going just a little bit too far.
Well, I thought you might say that, so I thought I'd bring up another picture if you didn't like that. I can just take this one off.
A picture of Larry Mills. Well, I vote for the picture of Larry Mills since he is leaving everything. And another reason, because with a picture of Larry Mills, it will bring back
a flush of memories.
We got coming up is a triple threat. How about a nice hint for the Joyner girls tonight? Me and Gary was trying to figure out which one is the prettiest.
Well, the two short ones are my size.
This next fellow we got coming up, he wrote this song. He's gonna do a real fine job on it. How about a nice hand for Mr. Billy Moore?
Take just a second to introduce the man you've met down here on the fiddle. After a while, you may get to hear him on the banjo, mandolin, a little bit of guitar. How about a big hand, Mr. Gary Murray? Right next to him on the lead guitar and singing, and he is just one of the best pickers you've ever heard. How about it for Mr. Steve Cohen? You hadn't heard his name mentioned all night unless it was in vain, but most of the time we say good things about him. He plays the bass, he helps a lot with the sound system, he's just done a tremendous job. How about a big hand for Mr. Randy Lloyd? Fellow that's in the back that you don't see, but if it wasn't for him, you wouldn't hear anything tonight. He does an awfully good job on the sound. How about it for Kevin King back there? Now this next young lady, I just love to introduce her because she's afraid I want to embarrass her.
Wait a minute, Gary. Wait a minute. The little short guy back here on the drums. How about a nice hand for Mr. Gary Cremins tonight? Ladies and gentlemen, he's not just a drummer, he's a band leader. He's got everybody together, got all the song lists. He's put in a hard week. Now, Gary, go ahead. Watch
it. Thank you.
This young lady who's going to sing this next song, I really appreciate her talent. I just enjoy being around her, and she's one of the best singers I've ever seen. How about it for Miss Dana Green?
Thank you.
something like that. This fellow loves Crowley's Ridge College and country music more than anybody I know. How about a big hand for a big fellow, Mr. Wendell Eubank?
Thank you, Gary. Can they see me all right?
I said, well, look at your double exposed.
That's the hardest thing I ever saw in any respect. Prima donnas. Prima donnas 1, 2, and 3. But most of all, pretentious. After all, these are the only performers that have to have their own announcer to introduce themselves tonight. Think about it. Now, I asked them earlier why they were scheduled so late in tonight's show. Well, the answer was they needed a little extra time to beautify themselves. So, but tonight, a little change. Yeah. But tonight, you're going to see a completely new version of this group, a more down-to-earth, back-to-basics group. So without any further delay, please welcome back to the Barnyard Bash for the second year in a row, straight from the hollows of Crowley's Ridge, Angie, Christy, and Karen, the Dixie Hicks.
I won't be a cure-all pill, and I won't run.
Neck wrong, and did I hear off towards the park to find that dirty rat who shot your paw.
Uh-oh, folks, we hire only the best around here. Now, Gary, remember, I'm an old, old man. If you play as fast as you normally do, I'll die right in front of 600 people. I don't want you doing it.
cooler at Kroger's. That's impressive, I say.
Pearl Beauregard.
Alice Pearl? Pearl's my name.
price of admission. Unless you paid to get in.
Steve, don't hurt yourself trying to carry that makeup bag.
We've got a fella coming out next that I think most of y'all are probably going to be familiar with. For about the last 13 years or so, he's been the president of this here institution. And I appreciate him a great deal because I get to work with him at church with one of my elders at Center Hill. And you quite well know what he means to this college, what this college means to him. How about a great big hand for Mr. Larry Bill?
Well, I've been flushed with excitement before, but never like tonight. And those Dixie Hicks, you need to know, you talked about that song I sang last year. Why do you think I'm retiring? I know you didn't come to hear me talk, but it wouldn't be kind of me to not express thanks for all the nice things that were said about Sarah and me tonight. And particularly, thank you to the WCRC for honoring Sarah. Somebody has said that behind every successful man, there's a good woman and a surprised mother-in-law. And my mother-in-law has certainly been surprised, but my wife has been totally supportive of me and everything that I've ever done. I've been the one in the spotlight a lot of times, but she's been the one that has done a lot of the back behind the scenes work and has done so many things to make this work go here, and it just wouldn't have been the same. It wouldn't have been possible without her. So thanks, baby. Appreciate it. I don't always get to rehearse these things as much as I like, and sometimes I think I know them. And tonight, my sister and brother-in-law walked in to my surprise from Paris, Texas, and made me forget everything I know. So between that and my age, maybe you'll forgive me if I have to look at this card every now and then. But I was glad that my sister and brother-in-law were able to come. We're sharing a couple of unique milestones in our lives. June the 30th, I retire. And a few days later, July the 4th, they'll celebrate their 50th wedding anniversary. My sister Louise Stewart and her husband Russell Stewart, they're back there at the corner. Be glad to shake hands with you if things are over. If you've been coming to these shows for a few years, you know that most of the time I try to sing something that I could sing to my wife and mean it. And that's certainly true of the song that I'm going to sing tonight. But at the same time, there's a line at the end of each chorus in this that applies to all of you. As we move toward transition in our lives.
Down on the sun to rise and the stars to
young lady that's about to come out. I intentionally put her this late in the show because I think she's worth waiting for. But Gary's going to have to tune before he can. Oh, no. Tell a joke. Kevin, I've got radio for a year coming through my monitor back here. I don't guess it matters to you. What'd you do, Gary? Broke a string on his fiddle?
Something I haven't done in about at least 12 years. And that's broke a string on his fiddle.
How old are you, Gary?
I'm not telling you.
I thought when you said something you hadn't done in at least 12 years, I thought you were talking about maybe combing your hair or something.
You couldn't go one night without saying something.
Well, you've already got your banjo too down the way, so I can insult you all night. Folks, I want to put in a plug for something that a lot of you probably are aware of. The Crowley's Ridge Roundup at Brooklyn on Saturday nights starts at 7 o'clock through the wintertime, at 8 o'clock when the time changes. And I play there most every week, and Gary plays quite a bit. Steve plays with us some, Dana plays some. Randy, when he just, you know, ain't got anything else to do, and we're really, really desperate, we get him to play with us. And you can come sometime, bring 50 of your favorite friends. Man, it's good entertainment, especially for $5. Gary is right now praying over his fiddle. Don't leave yet, because we've got one young lady and one man that is definitely worth staying for.
Places that I'd like to see.
very talented folks around here, folks. This this last fellow that's coming out, I put him last intentionally so you would have a reason to stay, for nothing else, to hear this young man. He's one of my favorite people, one of my favorite singers in the whole wide world, and one of these days you will hear him, if he wants to be, you will hear him on the radio, and I will get to say, I have played behind Mr. Chad. Related to see you.